Hi students, I am Kritika Srivastava again. Today I am going to teach you Standard 7 Science Chapter Number 1, Nutrition in Plants. Nutrition. What is nutrition? It is a mode of taking food by any organism and utilizing it by the body. Now where we utilize nutrition? We know we carry out day-to-day activities like to grow, to digest the food, life processes, to repair the damages our body occurs. So all these activities need energy. Now where do you get energy from? You get energy from food. Foods have components of foods in them. What are those components? Those are carbohydrates, fats, proteins, vitamins, minerals, etc. Our food contains all these components of food in them, which are necessary to carry out our daily activities. Now, all these components are called the nutrients. So, nutrition is connected with the word nutrients. Nutrients help to grow, repair damages, provide energy for life processes. Now, there are two modes of nutrition. Two modes of nutrition I have described here: autotrophic mode of nutrition and heterotrophic mode of nutrition. What do you mean by autotrophic mode of nutrition? Auto means self, tropic means nourishment, self-nourishment. Now the living organisms, those who produce their own food, means they make their own food, are known as autotrophs. Here, example for autotrophs are plants. They are also called as producers. Why producers? Because they produce their own food. Now you can say, the teacher, we also make our own food. So we are also producers? No. We make our food. We cook our food actually. But for cooking, we need the raw materials. That raw materials we get from the plants. Like if you cook rice, you get rice from the grains, from plants, again vegetables from the plants, fruits from the plants. So we are collecting the raw materials from the plants. But does plants eat fruits and vegetables? No, they give us. So they are the producers. Now coming to the second mode of nutrition is heterotrophic mode of nutrition. Here hetero means others and tropic means nourishment. Again, the organisms which depend on others for their nourishment are known as heterotrophs. Example for heterotrophs are animals and non-green plants. Yes, some plants are non-green plants, means they do not have chlorophyll, which we will see later. So here, first part, I am going to explain you about the autotrophic mode of nutrition, autotrophs and plants. Now, as soon as we hear the word autotrophic or autotrophs, the first thing comes in our mind are plants. Plants are the producers. Now, when we know that plants are the producers, that means they produce the food. How do they produce the food? They produce the food with the help of photosynthesis. You are already familiar with the word photosynthesis. Now, what does this photosynthesis mean? First of all, here the photo means light and synthesis means to combine. Light to combine. Light to combine what? Now plants need some raw materials to produce their food. What are these raw materials? These raw materials are water and minerals, carbon dioxide, and of course sunlight. Now, from where do plants get these raw materials from? Plants get raw materials such as water and mineral from the soil. It absorbs the water and mineral from the soil. Then carbon dioxide is present in air, as we know. You know that plants take in carbon dioxide and gives out oxygen. So what is actually that? Carbon dioxide is taken from the air by the plants. How they take it? There are tiny pores present on the surface of the leaf called stomata. Plants absorb the carbon dioxide present in the air by the stomata. Then sunlight. Sunlight we get from the sun. As you know, sun is the ultimate source of energy. Now leaves have chlorophyll, a green pigment called chlorophyll. It absorbs the sun's energy and helps the plants to perform the process called photosynthesis. So with all these together, this all raw material, that is waters and mineral, carbon dioxide and sunlight together, help the plant to produce its food. Now with the help of equation, I am going to explain how this photosynthesis process, or you can say reaction, occurs. Carbon dioxide plus water in the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll. Now students, this sunlight and chlorophyll both are very important factor for this reaction to complete. If there is no sunlight, then also the reaction will not be completed, and if there is no chlorophyll, then also this reaction will not be completed. So these two facts are very important for this reaction to complete. So carbon dioxide plus water in the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll gives out carbohydrates plus oxygen. That is, we get oxygen. Now you understood why we say that plants take in carbon dioxide and gives out oxygen. This oxygen is utilized by living organisms. We know we use oxygen to live, to breathe. Some leaves are of other color Now you can say, children, that some leaves are of wine color, you can say some leaves are yellow color, some leaves are also of red color. So you can ask me that, teacher, they do not perform photosynthesis. The answer is no, they also perform photosynthesis, because they have the green pigment called chlorophyll in them, but the other color pigments have covered them. So it doesn't mean that if the leaf is of wine color or brown color or red color, that means it doesn't have chlorophyll. It has a chlorophyll beneath that color. So you can say that some leaves are of other color, but they also perform photosynthesis process. That means they also make their own food. Now with the help of this figure, we can see how this photosynthesis process is completed. Sun, we get sunlight. Here I have shown a plant. Soil, roots are there in soil, you know. So with the help of roots, water and mineral are absorbed by the plant. Now how this process is occurring? You know, when you drink cold drink or any drink with the help of straw, you suck the water and you know that water comes up. Same way the plants suck up the water from the soil, water and mineral from the soil, and it reaches to the leaves. Now why to the leaves? Because this photosynthesis process is occurring in the leaves. So leaves are called, also called the kitchen of the plant, because the photosynthesis process, that is the food, is produced in the leaves. Now you can see that leaves have a tiny pore, which I already mentioned you, that they have a tiny pore called stomata. So also the leaf is green color. Green color means it has chlorophyll. So here all the raw materials help the leaf to perform the photosynthesis and make their own food. So in the next video, I will tell you about the heterotrophic mode of nutrition, and there are some plants which perform or which produce their food with the heterotrophic mode of nutrition. So in next video, I will tell you about the kind of plants which depend on heterotrophic mode and their examples. Up till then, you have to read the lesson, go through the points, and try to understand the figure given in the textbook. Thank you.